Hello everyone, Teacher Teresa here from VIP Kid Go Go Kid Class Talk, and now I'm back at Out School again because of the shutdowns in public school. I decided to teach poetry online again at Out School, and if I'm feeling ambitious, I might add some literature courses as well. So if you're looking for some extra income, I recommend Out School because right now classes are booming. Actually, I have one teacher friend who said she's making $7,000 this month on Out School alone. So that's pretty cool because she's only working part-time. So that's my tidbit of information for the day. And I also wanted to talk about using St. Patrick's Day in your classroom. Even at level one, you can teach that phrase, Happy St. Patrick's Day. Just show lots of St. Patrick's Day images. You can, if you don't have Manicam or Cam Twist, you could print them out. Or if you don't like wasting ink, which you're like me, I used to not use camera software. I used to just pick up my physical external camera and flash it back at my screen to show different kinds of images. Now I do have Cam Twist since I got a Mac, and so I can do these lovely things, and I really enjoy them. So there's that. I just open Google Images, and I just plop on things of rainbows and pots of gold and shamrocks and all the lovely things that are all St. Patrick's Day-ish. And I've even, for some of my older students, shown them art projects that they can do that are St. Patrick's Day themed. And that's really been going over well, especially in levels 4 and 5. Those kids really like to see that. What American kids do in art classes here for fun on St. Patrick's Day. So that's a great idea. If you haven't tried that, I would try that because kids really like it. Girls really love rainbows. I've done rainbows with the gold. I've done rainbows with leprechauns in them. I've done rainbows with unicorns. It's really fun. It's also a great time to start bringing in flowers, and these are all great rewards. And if you don't want to do any of that, that's fine too. You could go to the Props and Rewards group and look out what they have, because they have great resources too if you don't want to pull images from Google. Or if you don't want to use Google Slides, which is something else I like to do. But this time of the year, I use just straight Google Images, that I plop them into my Cam Twist. Actually, I could probably show you. No, it's not going to let me pull up Cam Twist on this recording software. That's a shame. I could have shown you some of the things that I've been using, but that's a pretty much gist. So I'll see you next time.